remember Deborah, the way she used to be, the places we would run to, the faces we would see. Yes, I remember Deborah, those precious memories. A city rising on the move, a simple yet progressive groove. I remember Deborah, and she remembers me. Yeah. She remembers me.
Welcome to the Tampa Native Show. Stay tuned now for the fastest 60 minutes in cable broadcast history. Live from the studios at TBCN, the home of the Tampa Native Show. Join your hosts, Mario Nunez, the 15-minute girl, and Steve Canella, as they celebrate growing up in Tampa. From Shock Armstrong to Shakey's Pizza, from Braddock Street to Buffalo Avenue, get ready to call in and tell us your stories, because sharing your memories has never been this much fun. And now, Mario Nunez, the 15-minute girl, and Steve Canella.
She remembers me.
Hi, Tampa Native Show fans. Welcome back to this, the Thursday night edition of the Tampa Native Show. My name is Mario Nunez, and Steve's got a big one. Apparently, that's what he told us just a few minutes ago before we went on the air. Was it hilarious? It was a moment in time.
A big question for tonight's show.
A big
show.
Question. Wow. That's what he meant. He had a big question.
About that.
I'm Mario Nunez. Again, this is the 15-minute girl, and that's Tampa Steve. I just wanted to see him turn red on camera. And
thanks
boy,
a lot.
Isn't he?
Never
now,
a dull moment.
Now, look, we've got a new set tonight here on the Tampa Native Show. We're working in this
black.
Sort of, yeah, this time tunnel effect with the black curtain and the black everything.
A little different.
Dark. Because we wanted to show up tonight for you bright in our colorful shirts, because tonight we're talking about a colorful time in Tampa's history.
Yeah.
And you know what that is? All right, we'll share it with you now. You know, before we had shopping malls and shopping towns, we had the outdoor plazas. We had Britton Plaza, we had mm-hmm. Northgate. You know, those were all outdoor type places where you had to go and bear the elements and the weather and between stores, and you had to kind of walk that little esplanade, remember, underneath the cover?
Mm-hmm. Hillsborough Plaza.
Before that, everybody went downtown. But then, of course, the 60s came and the move to suburbia, and they had to figure a new way to bring people into the shopping malls. So what'd they do? Out there on West Shore Boulevard, in the corner of Kennedy and West Shore, they built the West Shore Plaza Shopping City. Did you know that was the name of that facility?
No.
When it was first opened up? And did you know when it first opened up? That's September 28th of 1967.
Yeah.
So that's what we're going to be talking about tonight. We know that West Shore Plaza, or West Shore Plaza Shopping City, or as we later became affectionately termed West Shore Mall,
mm-hmm.
or the mall, because at that time it was the only one in play. So
yeah.
At that time, Anchor Stores, Moss Brothers and Penny's, and all the different stores in between. We're going to see how many of those stores you can remember tonight. How many you can name, and Steve, you got a big story for us or a big question?
Well, one of the main questions for tonight is, what was the chronology or the order of Moss Brothers at West Shore Plaza? Was it Moss Brothers and then Robinson's, Dillard's, Maison Blanche, I think was in there in that order as well, and then Sears, I think, eventually.
Or was it just Moss Brothers, and Steve has his facts completely wrong,
and
was it Robinson's?
Well, it did turn into Robinson's.
Negative. Robinson's was his own freestanding store at the end of the new mall when the new mall was built.
Oh, okay. You know
Moss
what?
Brothers
you're
was
right.
Moss,
you're right.
Moss Brothers, until,
yeah,
easy for me
way.
To say, until it
yeah,
closed its
right.
doors. However, here's a question for you that you might be able to answer. Moss Brothers had its own slogan, and we want you to be able to complete that for us. Two words. It was Moss Brothers, and there it is. I can't say it because you've got to call in and tell us.
How many words?
Two words.
He
two
said
words.
Two words.
Yeah, and tonight we're going to take all your phone calls. We're going to set records for phone calls. Hello, Dory is here with us tonight. She's.
And be nice because she's not feeling
it. She's a little bit under the weather. She's got that allergy thing going, man. You know, everybody's got it, and she's got it. But look, she showed up at 7:05 to take your calls, so you make sure you're calling in tonight and speaking with us. Tonight we're going to give away at our Bolita drawing a Tampa Bay Rays hat. We're going to give away a bumper sticker. We're going to give away a CD of Mike Baluha's I Remember Tampa. And all of it's going to go in one of our Tampa Native Show shopping bags. Because tonight we're going shopping at West Shore
Plaza
Shopping City. All right. All that said, fond remembrances tonight of West Shore. Did you work there? Did you go out there? Did you go hang out there? What fun things happened to you there? What embarrassing things happened to you there? Anything. Just your fondest remembrance of West Shore Plaza. But we got a couple of things we want to mention at the
outset.
That's
true. That's true.
So get ready with your stories.
And also,
get ready to call in.
Mentioning what you just said is there's more questions tonight than there are answers, you know?
There are.
Like, was there a record bar and a Camelot Music at West Shore Mall?
Very
good. Was there a Walgreens and a Woolworth at West Shore Plaza?
Very good.
So there's a lot of those questions that will be answered tonight. Well, let's take care of that business.
All right, let's do
that,
Steve. We want to go ahead and mention first off, yesterday, Eric Cups, our technical director, who tonight is over at Tropicana Field because he's at a production meeting over there. Tonight's technical director sitting in, the one, the only, irreplaceable, Jeff Haynes. He's behind the controls of the TriCaster. But Eric Cups yesterday had a birthday, and we want to say happy birthday,
happy
Eric.
Happy birthday, Eric.
One day. We know you had a great time because we talked to you yesterday. Also, say a quick shout out to a good friend, Cliff Callender, who resurfaced after many years of being on the run. Clifford, we're glad that you're back and you're doing good. And if you're out there watching us tonight, we know you are. Glad to have you back, bud. Lynn Ash, who's a renowned Tampa artist, who called us the other day and said, "Hey, Mario, I got a message from a mutual friend, your dentist and mine, Dr. William Geyer. He said I should give you a call." So Lynn Ash, we're going to be in touch with you very soon. And for absolutely sure, we're going to have you on the show at some point in time. So thank you for reaching out to us. Steve, you got some great, great, great news about USF.
Well, I sure do.
Oh, finally.
It's finally here. It's official now. The Tampa Natives Preservation Effort is now officially up on the USF server, the Special Collections, Digital and Special Collections, USF Libraries.
Great.
And if you go to tampanativeshow.com, we have a link now with a logo of USF logo near the bottom of the page. Click on that. It'll take you directly to the USF website. And that's incredible news because
it is.
And there you go.
That deserves a bell for
sure.
The
first one of the night. Deserves a bell ring.
It put us on a different level now. We enjoy doing the show. We come here every week for the last 2 years and never missed a show, but we enjoy it. But this kind of takes it to a different level.
It does.
I think it sets the show on a different trajectory, if you can say that. You know, now
it does.
We've now been officially recognized by the University of South Florida as we had been before, but now you can say we've cut the ribbon on that.
It's for real now.
Yeah, we're now among the wonderfully archived historical, I guess you would say, possessions that USF owns, which includes wonderful memoirs and things that were owned by the Gunsmart family,
for example, their collections.
Also, there was a Tony Pizzo collection, which is there as well. All the original plat maps of Tampa when Tampa was first being platted out by the city, all of that there. Now we're among those wonderful artifacts, so we're very proud.
And we'll be there in perpetuity.
Into perpetuity. Long after we're here, all of that will
be
there.
We will be artifacts.
So we want to capture your stories. And that's what we do here on the Tampa Native Show. So we make an appeal each and every week. And this would be a good time to talk about any type of photographs or any type of
video,
because in this medium that we're working, television, the videos work exceptionally well. So if you know, if you're sitting on Super 8 or 8 millimeter black and white or color movies, because that's what they were back then, and you'd like to share them with us, we promise to treat them with utmost respect and kid gloves and get it back to you in wonderful shape. But we'd love to have it so we can put it on our show, and again, put that in the file box over there at the University of South Florida once again so that those things can be recorded into perpetuity and kind of put in the history books.
Mm-hmm. You know, as a segue to the video, I just spoke to Maria Williams Tripp, and her father, you may remember, is National Auto Supermarket.
1711
East Hillsborough Avenue.
There you go.
Now, she is working on getting that video for us. It's the opening, grand opening of National Auto Supermarket, I think. I'm not sure if it was the late 60s or early 70s.
Mm-hmm. Oh, cool.
But in the process of finding that video, she found another family home video, 8mm, that she's it should be on the way to me right now. So I'm so excited. I'm like a kid at Christmas time right now.
Can't wait to open your presents.
I know, I can't wait. But apparently there's some old videos on here. I mean, not old videos, but old scenes of landmark places in Tampa. And so as soon as we get that done and get it edited, we'll bring it to you. We may have to do a whole show just on that video.
Well, we could certainly do a whole show on nothing but Moss Brothers.
Yeah.
Because Moss Brothers had been here in Tampa for all those wonderful years in the early 20s, if not the teens, when the Moss Brothers, literally, came to Tampa and started their retail store.
Also, the sporting goods store was on Gandy. That's where Dad worked.
That's right. That's right. Exactly. So, you know, we have all of this wonderful history, but tonight we're going to be talking about West Shore Plaza in its entirety, all of the stores. We're going to go to your phone calls here in just a minute. We want to remind you can also send us an email, That's show@tampanatives.com, show@tampanatives.com. Steve's got his computer open, as you can see on the desk.
We're ready.
He's ready to take your emails. The comment line, for those of you that can't get in tonight and you'd like to leave us a comment after the show, that's 813-920-2508. Operators will be standing by after the show. If you call now and leave us your Bolita number there, it won't be recorded. You'll miss out. And, of course, our website, as Steve mentioned earlier, is tampanativesshow.com. So, with all that said, let's go ahead and go to our phone lines. We're
going
to take caller on line 4, who apparently has an answer for us.
Oh,
another question.
Or another question. Caller, you're on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
Good evening. This is Hugh from South Tampa.
Hi, Hugh from South Tampa.
I had the answer to the Moss Brothers question.
Good. Okay.
Very good. Very good.
The full line was Moss Brothers.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Of course.
There
you
it
do.
Is. Moss Brothers, of course, Hugh Perrett.
And of course,
as we like to say here.
Of course he
nice
got
job,
it.
Of course Hugh. And you know, Hugh, you remembered that. Stevie remembered that. The 15-minute girl remembered that after a little bit of prompting. Who didn't remember that, right?
Yeah.
Who didn't?
That's right. It was it's like 1711 East Hillsborough Avenue. National
right.
Auto Supermarket.
Mm-hmm. National Auto Supermarket.
Hugh, Martin Luther King, before it was Martin Luther King, was known as?
Buffalo.
Okay, there you go. See, these are all little litmus tests that we do along the way to make sure everybody is, in fact, a bona fide native. Now, do you have a fond remembrance of West Shore Plaza? Did you remember going there as a teenager, early 20s? Mm-hmm. Tell us what you remember most, maybe your favorite store.
Well, the Walgreens store with the restaurant, for some reason that restaurant was awesome to me, you know?
Okay.
The food there, and they did, as I recall, they had a Woolworths and a Walgreens at the same time.
Yes, they did.
Yes, that's
yes
right.
they did. That's
right.
correct.
Mm-hmm. That has been confirmed.
That was a great place, going to a movie with a date, you know, when before they had, they dropped the movie theater, you know, afterwards, and then, of course, they got the movie theater back now, but that was awesome, too, when they had that in the 70s.
So they did have a movie theater in the 70s.
Yeah.
Did
Where
they?
Was it?
They had it in the 70s. It was there was a movie theater. It didn't have a long run, but it was there in the 70s.
Oh, okay. Okay. All right, Hugh. All right. That's breaking news.
That.
That's
yeah.
breaking news. Hugh, we're going to see if any of our other callers can dispel that rumor, because you're laying some news on us tonight. Look, I've got the schematic breakdown right here in my hand of West Shore. This is the blueprint, if you will. And there were actually some stores that weren't quite occupied when it opened up.
Yeah.
But I'm going to read the list of stores here in just a minute. We're going to take that in, and hopefully our callers will be able to call us and tell us, yeah, I worked there, and I went there, and I purchased there. And I've got a little bio that I'm going to read. This is about the grand opening. Again, this came out in the newspaper. The St. Pete Independent?
Yes.
St. Pete Independent.
St. Exactly. Pete Independent when just before the store's opening. So hang in there. I'm going to read that to you. Give us your Bolita number.
Number 7.
Of course.
Oh, it's taken.
7. Now, how are you going to pick
that's
7?
Keitha Abeni.
You know that that's always taken by Keitha Abeni.
Second choice.
Well, you want me to? I'll pick another one.
She emailed in, by the way.
I'll pick number 18.
Number 18, of course. Thank you, Hugh.
All right.
Good answer.
We appreciate you. Thank you, bud.
Thank you.
Thank you. Take care. Bye.
Take care. Bye. Bye.
And we'll bring that photo up when you start reading that schematic.
Yep. If you
photo
don't mind,
3.
Well, do you want to bring it up now while I read the grand opening?
Let's do that instead.
Ever?
Okay. That's picture number 1, Jeff.
Picture number 1, ladies and gentlemen. Bear with me while I read this advertisement for you. It's grand opening tomorrow, 10 a.m. It says 35 stores under one roof, West Shore Plaza Shopping City. Extra special grand opening values in all stores. It's kind of small. I'll read it to you. This is what it says. Rain or shine, shop in perfect comfort in a climate-controlled covered mall. West Shore Plaza, Tampa's regional shopping city with great golden triangle. It says it right here, golden triangle area. Let me read that again because that didn't make any sense.
No, it didn't.
Tampa's regional shopping city serving the great golden triangle area invites you to enjoy the ultimate in shopping comfort. No matter the weather outside, West Shore Plaza's enclosed mall is climate controlled for just the right comfortable temperatures inside. Come and see this exciting new shopping city with its many, many, many fine stores. Thrill to the atmosphere of sheer beauty while you shop. Take a relaxing moment at any of the picturesque fountains or a delightful breather on a mall bench and watch the shoppers go by. Yes, shopping will be fun at West Shore Plaza. 35 stores to serve you. With the widest selection of the finest quality merchandise available anywhere at unbeatable values. West Shore Plaza awaits you and your family. You'll agree, it has everything. Open every night, Monday through Saturday, till 9:30. Wow.
I didn't remember that they were open until 9:30.
9:30, closed on Sundays. Closed on Sundays.
Yeah, well, we knew that.
Also, I mentioned, and I put a little parentheses around it here, the Golden Triangle area. Golden Triangle area.
Another question.
Steve and I were wondering today, what was that in reference to? Now, I have a pretty good idea, but we're going to leave this open to our callers. So if you have a pretty good idea of what Golden Triangle area refers to, call us and let us know. I think I know.
And was it related to Golden Triangle store on Del Mabry?
No.
Which came first, the chicken or the egg, the Golden Triangle area or the Golden Triangle store, or were they not related at all?
I don't think they were related.
Let's hear from you, our callers and our viewers.
By the way, that flyer?
Yes.
Let's show this for a second here.
Sure.
If you notice, West Shore is spelled two words.
Now, correct.
Now it's one word, West Shore.
That's right. West and Shore with the W and the S capitalized.
Yeah, exactly.
Very good. Well, we've got a caller on line five. Let's see.
A first time caller.
Right ahead.
How do you know that?
Caller.
I don't know. I'm guessing.
Caller, you're on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
Hi. My name's Arlene Kaminsky, and I'm calling from Odessa.
Hi, Arlene Kaminsky. So happy to have you on the phone. Listen, a little birdie did tell us this is your first time calling. Is that true?
It is true.
As it happens here on the Tampa Native Show, everybody who's a first-time caller gets a bell ring. And not everybody gets a bell rung. I just want you to know, Arlene, that's a very special thing. Stevie wishes he get more bell rung, but
I only had one.
Well, listen, tell us tonight, we're talking about West Shore Plaza, but before we talk about West Shore, how'd you find us?
I found you on Facebook.
Oh, wonderful. That's wonderful. Right. That's wonderful. And we can assume, with a smile on our hearts, that you are a Tampa native as well?
Well, I am a Tampa native by choice.
Nice.
I was smart enough when I was a little girl visiting here to know that I wanted to be a Tampa native someday.
That's pretty cool. Well, that's another bell, Steve. Don't tell me when to ring the bell. Now, you stay on your side of the table. But I'll be honest with you, Arlene, you know, last week we had Ronnie Elliott on with us, and Ronnie had kind of the same type of a situation where at 6 years old, he lobbied his mom to move to Tampa because he had cousins here. So he got here as fast as he could also. What high school did you graduate from?
I graduated from Minooka High School in Minooka, Illinois.
Wow. So you came here after your high school graduation?
Actually, after college at Western Illinois University.
Oh. Very good. So you've been here since, I'm just going to guess, early 70s?
76.
Okay. 76 trombones. Okay. Yeah. So tell us now, what do you remember about West Shore Mall?
Well, I didn't live very far from there, so it was very convenient for me to go there.
Nice.
And job. And the first year I moved here, I had worked as a substitute teacher. They had the two high school combined over at Jefferson at that time.
Uh-huh. Tell me about it. I graduated in 76 from Jefferson. I had to share my school with Jefferson my senior year with Hillsborough. Right. I wasn't happy about that, by the way.
I was subbing there that year.
Oh, wow.
Wait a minute. Oh. Wait a minute. That's another bell ring. You're Miss Kaminsky.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. It gets better all the time. I wish I had my yearbook now. You were in, oh my gosh.
Oh, that's funny.
No, it's not funny.
Small world.
This is serious business. Now, I'm just trying to remember what discipline. Weren't you in the business hall? Didn't you teach business or did you teach history? Huh?
Well, I was subbing there that year for both schools.
But wait, I think I remember you being in our yearbook, Ms. Kaminsky. I really do. I mean, this is not funny. I'm being very serious. What I do remember, too, was that Pam Campbell went with Joe Tomasello our senior year, and it was scandalous. And we love those people now to this day. Joe T., if you're out there watching, and Ms. Campbell, who stayed in the school system and ultimately went on to become an administrator, I think recently retired, or maybe she's about to. But
right.
We had a very, very young staff, so it surprises no one. We're talking about Jefferson now instead of West Shore Plaza. Surprises no one that you were there because it was a crazy fun school.
It was great. That big open court, it was fantastic.
Yep, and we had a wonderful principal. Our principal, do you remember Sam Horton?
Yes, I do.
The late, great Sam Horton, wonderful man.
Always looking for excellence.
So you found us on Facebook. We're not going to talk about Jefferson tonight, even though we've talked too long about that. Tell us about West Shore.
West Shore was really a beautiful mall. It was very modern.
Yes.
And they opened the Farrell's Ice Cream Parlor.
Farrell's.
Yes, there it is.
And when I was in college, I had worked my way through school, part of the way singing with bands.
Okay.
In Chicago area.
There you go.
And when I came down here, I found out they wanted singing waitresses. So I thought, oh, what a fun way to continue singing for a while. So I went over there and I applied for a job just for the summer. And so for 2 months, I was a singing waitress at Farrell.
How fun.
That's no awesome. Way you weren't.
Oh, it was great. I loved it.
So now we find out that not only do we have the substitute teacher at Jefferson when I was there, but we also have the singing waitress. The famous singing waitress from Farrell's?
Exactly.
Was there only one?
I'm getting tired of ringing that bell. That's pretty cool.
And if she sings a song, it'll be another bell.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, what types of songs would you have sung?
Oh, we sang Happy Birthday and a little Happy Anniversary song. Mm-hmm.
Didn't Farrell's waiters and waitresses, am I having a flashback here? Was it kind of a ragtime thing happening there? Did the women have the skirts and the guys have the armbands and the straw hats? Am I going somewhere else with this? Where am I going?
Oh, you are absolutely on the money.
I'm going to ring the bell again. I am. I'm going to do it again. Oh, I can't because the 15-minute girl said I can't. All right. Thank you, though. I remember that now. See, the things we remember. Arlene, thanks so much for calling us.
Thank you,
so
Arlene.
Appreciate this. This is our highlight for the show,
yeah,
I have a feeling.
Cool.
We're very, very cool.
I'll tell you one other story very quickly.
Please.
I think you'll enjoy.
Please.
And that is the Rowdies used to come in there once in a while.
Oh,
okay.
Interesting.
And they would drive us crazy.
I bet.
Time. They made me the head waitress at their table. And they had given us such a hard time, all in good fun, of course, that they took out all their silver change and they spelled out "Goodbye, Arlene."
Oh, did you take a picture of it?
We must have a picture of that somewhere.
It was a great tip, let me tell you.
Yeah, I bet it was. I bet it was, because back then, 50 cents bought you a whole lot.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, let's ask Arlene. Arlene, do you have any photos of Farrell's ice cream?
Do you know what? I'd have to dig around to see if I do. I can't say for sure.
If you do, let us know.
Yeah, that'd
please,
be
if
great.
You do, because as you heard at the top
awesome.
Of the show, we've recently gone live with our website connection, and our collection is now all of these shows that we've created over the last 2+ years, almost 100 shows now, are archived on the USF website server. So we would love to be able to include those photographs if you have them. So do us a small favor and dig around a little bit and find those if you will. And if you do, send them to us.
I sure will look for them. Thanks for having me.
You bet. We might just have to bring you in and let you sing us a tune once or twice. And maybe you can sing us a little dedication one of these shows. Thanks, Arlene.
Thanks for calling.
Lucky drawing number between 1 and 75. We're going to give away a gift here in a little bit.
Okay. You want me to say it out loud?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, because if you don't, we won't know what it is.
I'm going to write it down.
I can't keep it a secret,
no,
huh?
No.
71.
71 it is. Thank you so much, Arlene. That's a wonderful call for
that's
tonight.
A great,
that's a great way
call.
To lead the show off. Thank you, honey. We appreciate it. We're here every week on Thursday, so look in on us.
I sure will. You sound like a lot of fun.
Thank you, Arlene. Thank Thanks. You. Take good care.
Thanks,
okay,
Arlene.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
What
that?
A wonderful call.
How about
and
that?
Your teacher.
Cool.
Yeah, no,
what
I remember Ms. Kaminsky. I remember Ms. Kaminsky. And now when I get home, I'm going to have to
that's amazing.
Open my yearbook and for sure, yeah, no, and look her up.
That's
absolutely.
Typical for Tampa, though. That's the way
West Shore Plaza.
Yeah.
You guys call us now. We know you're out there watching. We know you got stories of West Shore Plaza. Don't make me talk the entire hour because
no,
I've got stories and I can fill the entire hour, but so can Steve.
Oh, we can too.
I have a story too. I worked
work
at
there.
West Shore.
She worked at Learner's Shop, so we're going to get to that right after this call. Line 4. Do it, baby.
Caller, tell us your name and where you're calling from.
It's Tom from New York.
Hi,
Tom. From New York.
Sounds terrific.
Hey, Tom, what's going on, man?
We're just hanging here. Me and Carolyn are just hanging, watching the show.
Attaboy. Well, tell us about what you remember about West Shore Mall.
You know I don't remember.
Good luck on that.
I know you don't, man. It was a trick question. I got you. It was a trick question.
Where I grew up, there wasn't any strip malls. We had to drive 15 miles to go to the closest mall. And still today, there's no mall there.
And what I remember about West Shore Malls, there were no strippers there either. Huh? Gotcha. Yes. No, there were no strippers. That was the Tiger's Den, another place altogether.
Different show.
Did you just ring the bell?
I did. Because, did you hear the joke? It was a good one. I said, what we remember about West Shore Mall was there were no strippers there either, because you mentioned strip mall. And a little bit later on, when you watch the replay of the show, you'll get it. It might be funny then.
Bummer,
there were no strippers.
Right. But West Shore Mall was the only store like that of its kind. And it wasn't very big. Now you go, you don't know where the old mall footprint actually is.
Yeah, I don't like it now.
It's enclosed now. It's
too big.
Just too big. But back then, it was really something special.
There is some place up here they tried to restore and bring back the strip mall, bring back the inside mall to it. But, times are tough.
Yeah. No, there's no money to do that right now, for sure.
Yeah.
Absolutely, for sure. Tommy, man, we're glad you called us back. Give us your Lucky Bolita number.
That is 42, and I wanted to say congrats on the USF archive.
That's good. Thank you, bud.
We're very happy about that.
It is a big deal, man. And people don't realize, you know, we've been working at it for a little while. Stevie especially has been working at it, and it finally came to fruition. So, you know, after the show, not now, after the show, go on the website and check it out and click on there, and it'll take you right into the
archives. I sure will.
All right, buddy. Thanks for calling.
Take care, Tom.
Thank you, Tommy.
Bye.
Tom from New York. Hadn't heard from him in a little bit. I'm glad he's doing okay.
We heard from Big Mike Virginin.
Oh, yeah, email. Read that, and I'll get online just a second.
By the way, his Lucky Bolita number is number 58.
58.
And he writes, Mike Pedrinan writes, "Hola, guys. Tune in tonight to watch my favorite show in Peeps. Spencer's gift was always worth checking out, especially the new Bridget calendars that came out. How about National Shirt Shop for everything cool? Knickknacks. Roland Shirts, pre-Mr. Man.
Yes.
Great memories always, strolling for chicks, and the AC was always a plus, and getting a slice of pizza at Woolworths, the best.
Yep.
What was it at Woolworths?
Slice of pizza.
Oh, yeah, it was. Yeah,
Apparently, they had really good pizza there.
That good pizza there, like they had good ice cream at Farrell's, absolutely. Somebody mentioned also Walgreens. They had a counter at Walgreens.
Where there was a counter there, too.
Grilled cheese sandwiches and tomato soup.
Yeah, Hugh said they had good food.
Was it Hugh?
Well, we have a lot of comments.
Look at the lines, Stevie, look at the lines.
A lot of comments from Facebook about the memories of Woolworths and Walgreens and Westshore Mall.
Let's get the calls. If we get a minute or two, we'll get back to those and read those as well. Caller, let's see, we're going to go to line five. Line five. Caller, you're on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
Tony Gonzalez from Ybor City.
Excuse me?
Wow, that's a voice
Tony
from the
Gonzalez.
Past.
I'm going to ring a bell on Tony
that's
Gonzalez
amazing.
Because Tony
Hi,
Gonzalez
Tony.
Used to call this show all the time, and we wondered what happened,
happened to
him.
You?
I was traveling, man. I only got 24 states to go.
Oh, wow.
Lord, he was born a rambling man.
Yeah.
Well, welcome back,
Tony. Welcome
Tony.
Back. We missed you, bud.
Hey, I had to put you on.
Good to hear from you.
There you go. Very good. Well, tell us your fond remembrance of West Shore Plaza.
Well, West Shore Plaza for me was, do you know that they had bus service out in that? They added bus service to that area out there.
I would assume that you know what, at the time, we lived so close.
I lived really close.
So we went with our parents, and then later we drove ourselves. But, if you came from other parts of town, East Tampa, downtown Ybor City, I imagine the bus brought you right.
I think they probably did.
And they dropped you off probably right there on West Shore, no? Right there on West Shore just...
Right there on West Shore.
North of Kennedy, I remember.
So they would turn and go down West Shore because... A young man out of the Army, that was a good bus for him, and I used to drive that bus.
Oh, nice. So you took people to West Shore, man.
Well, part of the time.
Okay,
yeah, that's interesting.
Okay, that was part of the route.
Yeah.
Well, it was a great place to hang out, absolutely a great place to hang out.
Yeah,
And we hadn't seen anything like that in Tampa up until then, you know, so
it was
kind of new. And, of course, the stores, Moss Brothers and Penny's, and I'm going to read the list of stores in just a second, but... Tony, so glad to have you back,
yes,
man.
Yes, definitely.
And don't be such a stranger. You here?
No, I'm going to be here for a while because my daughter's going to be coming down to stay with us for a while.
Good.
Oh, good.
I'll be here for a while now.
Great.
Good, Tony. Great. Well, you just have to know that we talk about you all the time because this is how we talk about, hey, whatever happened?
We
to
did.
Tony?
I know. We were talking about that.
Because Tony would always call us, and it would be the same thing. It'd be like, caller, you're on the air.
What happened to Tony?
Tell us your name and where you're calling from, and you'd always answer the same way. This is Tony Gonzalez, and we missed you.
Hey. What I do now is I probably won't be traveling again until November. My son will be coming home.
Good.
Going to Texas, so
good.
I'll go make that my headquarters, and then I'll travel through New Mexico and all the Western
states. Well, you can always catch us online if you can figure out the time change where you might be. Thank you, Tony.
Give us your Bolita number.
Your Bolita number before you go?
31.
31.
Okay.
Thanks. That's Tony Gonzalez, y'all.
Here,
thank you, Tony.
Thanks, Tony.
Bye, Tony.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Oh, wow. Hey,
let's read that, yeah.
Yeah, let me just throw the stores out at you for your considerations,
and
ladies and gentlemen.
That's picture number
three. If you want to bring up the picture, bring up the graphic with, look at that, Tony Gonzalez. That's great, man. Great to hear from Tony again. If you'll bring up the graphic, which picture?
Picture number three.
Number three. And I'm going to go through and read the stores in order.
This is a great photo.
One through 14. And I know it's kind of hard to see. I hope you guys can see it there at home. But store number one, which is right up there, just to the left and below Moss Brothers, was Wolf Brothers. Store number two was Colony Shops. Store number three was Baker's Shoes. Number four was Lerner's Shops. And, of course, that big store in between there was Woolworth's. You can't miss that there.
Woolworth's.
Yes, stay out of the Woolworth's. That's funny. That's a quote from one of our favorite movies. The other anchor was J.C. Penney, Jacques Penney as it's known today, or J.C.P. as the hipsters want to call it. Back the other way, store number 13 was Spencer's Gifts, right there on the corner. We all remember where Spencer's was, right across from Lerner's. Store number 14, remember there was a cleaner and laundry there. It was Marquis Cleaner and Laundry, okay? Laundry and dry cleaning.
I don't remember that.
Store number, going back the other way, store number 12 was Walgreens Drugs. Store number 11 was Talone or Taloney. Hope I'm pronouncing that correct. Barbershop. Hmm. If anybody knows about that barbershop, call us, because I have vague remembrances of that.
Maybe there's some
relatives. But there may be somebody out there that remembers getting their hair cut there, cutting hair there. Store number 10 was Orange Bowl. Didn't that, you go in there to get orange juice and orange Julius and orange bars?
I sure did.
Store number 9 was the George M. O'Neill Company, or as we used to refer to it as O'Neill's. It was O'Neill's Card Shop. That's where you went in to get your holiday cards and your sweetheart cards. Store number 8 was National Shirt Shop, NSS. Store number 7 was Barron's of Tampa. Store number 6 was Piccadilly Cafeteria. Wow, Piccadilly.
I love that place.
Amazing, amazing Piccadilly. And store number 5 was Jarman's Shoes. And if I'm not mistaken...
That was a men's store, Jarman's.
Yep, Jarman's. And if I'm not mistaken, a little bit later on, there was a Tom McCann in there.
Yeah.
There may have been a Hush
Baker's,
Puppy Shoes.
Baker's, I think
shoes.
Baker's, yeah.
Baker's might have been
in there.
I know
they were downtown,
there was,
too.
Thank you for bringing that photograph up for us, Jeff. We appreciate that. Remember... It was, no, thank you for bringing that one up. You can come back to us. I appreciate it. There was also JCPenney's Auto Center that was out in the parking lot, which is, I think, more or less where either the Sears Auto Center is now. And, of course, Firestone is still there as well. Moss Brothers. What do we remember about Moss Brothers? Moss Brothers had a Moss Brothers, of
restaurant.
Course. But the restaurant upstairs. Yeah. Do you remember the Suncoast? Was the
Suncoast restaurant?
Suncoast restaurant. It was a fancy kind of place.
Yeah,
white
it was.
Linen. And
Uptown.
A place where you went when you celebrated special occasions, a graduation from high school, bar mitzvah, first communion.
The 90s, I think.
Yeah, no, if you had
dinner up there pretty much.
All the time?
Lunch. When I was working. They had a great steak salad that was just like out of this world.
Yeah, and I remember the broccoli cheese soup for whatever reason. I don't remember that. But I also remember going there in your after six tuxedo.
It was a really nice
restaurant. Know, that's where you went for homecomings.
Yeah. It was
a nice place to go.
Speaking of Moss Brothers, though, I don't know if it's true or not, but somebody posted this on Facebook that Moss Brothers had an auto center as well. Is that possible?
I don't remember. It might have been out by
the
sporting center.
That ultimately went to...
The sports store.
You know, they could have.
That was on Gandy. I don't remember that.
I know J.C. Penney's had a sporting goods department because that's where I bought my first bowling ball.
Yeah.
How about that?
That's a good
J.C. Penney's, and I remembered like it was yesterday. I got it around Christmas time. It was a black rubber, hard rubber ebonite bowling ball. It was a 10-pound ebonite, and I got it with a red and black bowling bag and bowling shoes, and, man, I was hot, and bowling was cool. Or as the 15-minute girl would have you know, no, it wasn't.
No, it wasn't.
But I bowled in the junior leagues over there at Dale Mabry Lanes, and that's another show for us, Steve.
That's a whole different
But we
show.
Have two you callers know? Holding, so.
All right, let's go to line 4. Caller, you're on the air, or in this case, callers, you're on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
Hey, kids, it's Debbie and Rose.
See there, Debbie and Rose. I knew it was callers.
How y'all doing?
We're
great.
Doing great. Tell
Good,
us about
you.
Tell us about West Shore Mall.
Well, listen. I grew up on Cleveland Street.
Yes.
Right there.
A bicycle ride away.
Yeah, Cleveland right there. Yeah. We grew up right close to each other, Debbie.
I rode my bicycle there every day.
Cleveland between what and what?
Well, right off of Kennedy there.
No, I know where Cleveland. Cleveland runs parallel to Kennedy. Between, were you on the east or west side of West Shore?
Horatio and Cleveland.
There you go. That's what I needed to know. Horatio and Cleveland. Did you go to Grady?
I went to Tampa Catholic.
So you went to Christ the King?
Hesperides. I didn't mean Horatio.
You meant Hesperides.
He's my bad.
Yeah, Hesperides. That's okay. It's early.
It's an age. Anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So now listen. First of all, why are y'all in black?
We're not in black.
It's
We're
sexy.
In bright
look
colors.
Look at that blue. Look at that blue banner there. How sexy is that? I mean, it wouldn't look that good if it wasn't against a black
We're
background.
We're just doing
We're
different
always trying
things.
New things.
Now listen. Now what I wanted to say was, first of all, I need a bell.
Well,
a
you
bell?
Gotta earn that bell. Go ahead, give it to me.
Okay, I have dialed in for 10 minutes.
All right.
The recording, okay?
Yes.
So, my patience, I need a bell.
You need a bell?
That's a bell.
Yeah.
No!
Oh, ooh, you got punked. You got punked on the show. That's our first punk in 2.5 years. But keep talking. You may still get that bell. Tell us about West Shore. other than there was a short bike ride. Come on, Debbie. And tell Rose I got her check today, by the way. You guys are in for the 12th.
Go up there every time.
Okay.
And let me tell you, the body shop. I know it's already been talked about, but I loved it because when you walked into the dressing rooms, it was, you opened a car door.
All right. Now, you remember that, right? Was it the body shop or merry-go-round? It was the body shop, wasn't it?
Yeah. Body shop was the car doors.
That's right, body shop because it was the car doors, remember?
Yes,
it was very, very cool.
Now.
Okay, keep going. What else do you remember?
Shop.
Come on, give me the
good
stuff.
They were pink, and Mariners, and 579, and Spencer's, and then they closed up and they went over to Tampa Bay Center.
Bay Center. It wasn't Tampa Bay Mall. Let's get that
Bay
correct.
Center.
You got that right, Tampa Bay Center. You're getting closer to that bell.
Oh, and I love you guys.
We love you, too.
Oh, thanks. We love you,
Did you ever
too.
Go to Moss Brothers to eat a fancy meal? Look at that 15-minute girl gave you a bell ring on that one.
When they went out of business, it was so sad, but they had 70% off. I had to go.
Yes, yes, yes. Moss Brothers, of course.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Debbie.
Thanks,
thank you.
Guys.
We got your number. We can't wait to see you on the 12th, if not before.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we got tickets. We're going.
Yeah,
good,
and by all means, if you have some friends out there that want to join us, we still got room.
Yes, we do.
And you have Rose's number.
Yes.
Yes.
It's nice seeing you guys again.
You as well,
you.
Debbie. Welcome home, and thank you, and thanks for being a big fan.
Oh, yeah.
Take care.
I am.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
They're so nice.
You know, my dear friend David Guderian, who's in San Francisco, who went to Grady, Coleman, and Jefferson with me, he lived, I believe, off Hesperides, or it's actually Hesperides, but he lived off Hesperides right there off Cleveland, too, and I didn't get to ask Debbie if she knew David Guderian.
We
and he had a younger brother named Daniel, Dan. And a younger sister, too, so maybe he knew.
We have a caller.
All right, let's go to
line five
and see who awaits. Caller, you're on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
I'm from Tampa, Florida. My name is Gilbert Menendez.
Gilbert Menendez. Let me write that down,
Sounds
Gilbert,
familiar.
Because...
Welcome in, Gilbert.
A little... Somebody in my ear told me that this might be your first time calling. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
All
cool.
right, fantastic. That's just for you, Gilbert. Now, you have to be a Tampa native because a name like Gilbert, you just sound like a Tampa native to me. You sound like a Tampeño. Where are you from?
Well, I was born in Connecticut, but I've been here since 68.
All right, 68 is good. You went to high school here?
Yes, I went to Jefferson.
You went to Jefferson High School. Where did you graduate?
80.
All right, just a little bit behind me. You graduated, I think, with a good friend of ours, married to my cousin, Captain Buddy Fernandez. Perhaps you went to school with Buddy Fernandez? Does the name sound
I don't know. I knew a lot of Fernandez.
Oh, well, didn't we all?
That's a lot.
That's
a
not
lot.
A revelation to us. Gil, what do you remember about West Shore Mall?
Well, a lot of things. Well, I remember Hunt's Hobby Shop.
Okay, was
that
there?
I forgot about that. I forgot about
Was that at West Shore? Hans.
No, I don't.
Not
I don't
Chan's. Not
that.
Chan's. Now he's saying
Hans. I think Hans or Hans.
I don't know.
Wow, okay. No, go ahead. Keep going. Keep going. What else do you remember?
Okay, well, Piccadilly there.
Yes.
I remember the Walgreens cafeteria.
Yes.
Okay, and you know they had all these nice desserts and the cooler displays showing all these
pies and cakes going around.
Mm-hmm.
Old style.
Yeah, cakes, and they had like what you call it, Jello with whipped cream on it and everything.
Yes.
They had a fountains in the middle, didn't they?
Yes, they did. We have a photograph we're going to show in just a couple of seconds on
right
that very thing.
Right.
There were three.
Yes.
There were three fountains, one in the middle and two on either end. And people used to throw coins in there, man, because you know what else you do with a fountain?
Right. Right. Exactly.
I don't think it was designed for that. It wasn't a wishing well, but people turned it into one.
Yeah, but I do remember the fountain.
Oh yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
Uh-huh.
Great place to hang out, man, on a hot summer afternoon. You know, go to the mall. It's air conditioned. You can ride your bike there if you live close enough. How did you find us, Gilbert?
I was surfing the internet, and I'm always looking for old photographs of Tampa. I'm very nostalgic, so...
As are we.
I guess I just accidentally stumbled onto your website, and I was just watching them, and it's really neat, all of the old pictures that you show it through, and of course, I watch you on Facebook and everything.
Great. Well,
okay,
Steve does a wonderful job,
yes,
man,
he does.
Keeping our website up to date, and... That's really his baby. He's the IT department.
IT department.
We tease him here because, you know, we ride him unmercifully. But he does a great
job.
All right, I do.
Oh, yeah.
But he does a great job with that. And if you found our website, that's all because Steve is constantly trying to get a better position, leverage us on the Google page and on Bing and wherever
that's
we
really
can.
Cool.
So that really warms our heart to know that you found us that way.
And Gilbert, also go to Facebook, Tampa Natives. Actually, you can find it from the TampaNativeShow.com mm-hmm. website. Click on the Facebook group, Tampa Natives, as well as the Tampa Natives Show, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you'll see it. There's over 1,500 yeah. photos now.
A lot of photos yeah. there that you might be very well interested in.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah, great. Yeah, I'm always looking. I mean, I buy all the books and everything, Tampa history books, yeah. Historic things, like that book from John Sinchet.
Johnny Sinchet's
yes,
been on the show,
been on
with
our
us
show
three different times. He's a great friend of the show, so we know Johnny.
Yes.
Johnny's a good guy, and he loves Tampa history just like
yeah.
we do. That's what we do here, Gilbert. Every Thursday we pick a topic and we talk about it, and you know the passion just comes out, and fans like yourself find us. So what we'd like to do is make an appeal to you to reach out to your circle of influence and your friends and
let
tell them,
everybody
hey, man,
know.
Found this great show about yeah. old Tampa, and tune in because
yes.
we're here every Thursday.
Spread the word.
All right, fantastic, fantastic.
Do you have a favorite number between 1 and 75?
Lucky number between 1 and 75.
26.
We got it. We got
yep.
you down. Thank
okay.
you, Gilbert. Thanks so much for calling us, for finding us, and we really appreciate you.
All right, thanks.
Take
bye
care.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
We got a news alert from Dan Perez.
That's so cool.
Breaking news alert from
Is
Dan Perez.
Is it 15 minutes now?
Oh. Well, he thinks Moss Brothers was October 29th, 1966,
yeah.
from an article.
When it closed?
No, when it opened.
Oh,
that's,
when it opened.
That's Moss Brothers, though. Maybe not the mall. It was completed maybe 6-7 months later, possibly.
Oh, okay.
Maybe somebody
okay.
can verify that for
We're
us.
We're at the 15-minute mark.
Excuse
so.
Me?
Yes.
Already?
The 15-minute girl?
I just dropped it on you.
Dang.
Where did the show go?
Almost.
No.
That's right. That's what I'm thinking. No. 15 minutes, girl, it's got
we
us
have
again.
Two
well,
callers.
We got two callers.
Yeah.
We
calls
knew tonight was going to be one of those nights. We knew tonight
yeah.
was going to be one of those nights. Caller, you're on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
Philip Nunez, Tampa.
Philip Nunez,
Tampa,
that sounds
Florida.
Familiar.
How you doing, Pop?
Okay, man. Okay.
For those of you that don't know, that's my pops on the phone right there, Philip Nunez. Hey, you got a fond remembrance of West Shore Mall, and I'm not talking about the one from today. I'm talking about the one from yesterday.
Listen, I think I'm right. I don't know. There was a grocery store called Pantry Pride.
Pantry Pride, yes.
I didn't mention that when I was going through all the stores. I'm
you
glad
are correct.
You called me out on that because it was clear as day on that breakdown,
yeah.
that blueprint.
It was towards the end of the mall.
Yes, in the back.
It was
in the back.
Well,
yeah.
Let me think. It was on the east side of the mall, so it was off of West Shore. You could actually, it was connected to the mall.
Yes.
I'm not sure if you could get to it from inside the mall. It was kind of a separate building.
I think it was.
And you
separate,
had to, you
yeah.
know, access it through its own doors. But I remember Pantry Pride. Now, if I'm not mistaken, in my family, of which you were a big part, being that you are my father, we used to shop at Cash and Carry. Cash and Carry was our default store. We weren't quite a Publix family, and every once in a while we would go into Pantry Pride, but it wasn't really our first choice, right? Correct? Am I correct on that?
You're correct. You're absolutely correct, yes.
Because we looked at people who went to Pantry Pride askant, didn't we? We kind of looked at them like, oh, they shop at Pantry Pride. We don't know who they are. I'm teasing, of course, because a lot of people went to Pantry Pride if it was the closest one. But
yeah.
remember, Caddy Corner across the street on the southeast corner of Kennedy and West Shore was another Cash and Carry.
I didn't shop at Cash and
Carry. Remember that?
Cash and Carry, I thought that was by... Where was the other one?
Where Eckerd's and Montgomery Ward's was.
Yeah.
Yes, but there was another one there for the people that were in Beach Park and where Debbie Palavides just said she lived on Horatio or Hesperides, excuse me, in Cleveland. There was a Cash and Carry there, which was next to Rexall Drugs. There was the Baskin and Robbins in that little strip center there.
Yeah.
Of course you have to remember that. But for some reason, even though that one may have been closer to our home, we went to the one in West Tampa because we just felt comfortable there.
Because it was with Tampa.
Because it was with Tampa, bro.
The biggest, and now it's one of the smallest.
Yeah.
Right. So that's what you remember, Pantry Pride. Anything else?
Right.
Just anything else about that mall? Did you shop at any of those men's clothier stores? Or?
Well, that time, you know, I was working in the Columbus split shit, and I didn't have much time. Your mother did the shopping. In fact, your mother bought my clothes, you know. She bought me clothes for me, you know.
Okay, so she probably went to JCPenney's, although she bought her stuff at Moss Brothers. I get it. That's how it works sometimes, man. You know, just
what's your favorite number,
Give
Gramps?
Us your leader number there, big guy.
I have to say 29.
29 it is. Good luck to you. We hope you win tonight.
All right, good show, babe.
Thank you.
Thanks for calling, Gramps.
Thanks for calling Philip Nunez. That's Philip Nunez.
My favorite part of that call?
Yeah, put up that picture from the inside of the mall with that. I hope it's the one with the fountain so we can... we can show the fountains and we can prove Gilbert correct. Yeah, there it is. Look at that. Look at
there
that. See
is.
The fountain right
fountain
there
right
in the middle, Steve, right across from Woolworths?
I remember it like it was yesterday.
Oh, wow, man. Can we just go back there? Is
I would
it possible?
Just like to take a trip back in time to old Tampa and go to all the
in
old
general.
Great places
yep,
that
in
we
general.
Had. Yeah,
in general. In very much general because we talked
and
about
it. And have it be exactly the same.
The 15-Minute Grill and I just talked about this yesterday, Steve.
Yeah.
We didn't talk to you about it because we hadn't talked to you since.
He wasn't with us.
But, you know, Tampa has changed so radically.
Well, we talk about that all the time.
You know what I mean? It's like... From the earliest days, from let's say the whole decade of the 60s, 70s, and even up until the early 80s,
yeah.
It was just so colloquial, man. So
it was perfect.
So local. We had it all to ourselves.
It changes so many ways, so many levels.
You couldn't go to West Shore Mall and not know half the people that you saw in the mall.
Yeah.
And for that matter, when Tampa Bay Mall opened up, the same thing.
Yeah.
Maybe a little less so. But now, you're lucky if you see one or two people that you might know.
We
and there's so many different places to go. I think
no matter where you went, Tampa, you
and
ran into somebody.
And they're just tearing down everything everywhere you look anymore. They're tearing
it's
down
very
old buildings that should still be there and putting up pieces of junk.
It's
well
all right, 15-Minute Girl.
It makes
with
me
the
mad.
Pieces of junk commentary.
It makes me mad.
Here we go. Let's get to line
five.
And
we have a couple
before
emails,
too. We get too sad, because I get verklempt, and
yes,
then
you
know, I get weepy, and I don't want to do that. Caller, you are on the air. Tell us your name and where you're calling from.
Angelo Ramore.
There he
Hi,
is.
Angelo.
Hey, Angelo.
Hey, Angelo.
How y'all doing?
We're doing great. You got a West Shore Mall story for us?
Yeah, you guys might remember in the early 80s, they used to put on an antique car show inside the mall.
Hmm. Let me think. Let me scratch my beard because that's usually what I do when I'm thinking.
It was always on Father's Day.
Oh, it was always on Father's Day.
Right, in the early 80s.
Do you remember, Steve?
I don't remember.
We used to put about 15 cars in there.
Why would Angelo remember
that? I bet
that?
You Michael
Because
would
he
remember.
Has a 1965
Yeah, because
Ford
he's a
Mustang.
Car. He's a car aficionado, and he loves old cars, and he remembers
car
shows.
Which we rode in that car for Gasparilla.
Yeah, we would put about 15 cars in that mall, but at the time, they had already extended it back I guess where Robinson's and all that used to be.
Yeah.
That was the new mall. Acuerda, that was the new part. That was the new mall down that whole strip there.
Exactly.
And that's when they started to really
made
mess
it
things
too
up.
Big.
Yeah. And
it still wasn't too big, but it was
there
big.
Used to be a lot of people that would come out there on Father's Day to bring their fathers in wheelchairs and
to
everything.
To look at
else.
All the cars.
We had a real good time talking to the old guys about the cars. And,
yeah.
And we put some beautiful cars out there.
And how would you drive them in? Through the double doors on the side where Penny's was? Because they were big entradas there.
Well, we'd bring the cars in by where Lerner's was.
Yep. Right there by J.C. Penney's.
Yeah.
I'm looking at the breakdown of the map. And
we'd do it, after 10 o'clock at night. And we were there till about midnight putting cars in there.
Wow. You had the place all to yourself.
Quite an undertaking.
On Friday night, so the cars were there all day Saturday. Mm-hmm. And all the way to Sunday afternoon, and after they cleared the mall, then we took the cars back out.
Well, you've been in the car show business for a while,
long time.
Oh yeah, I got into it in 1980.
Wow, that's
very
so
nice.
Cool. Angelo, tell us your bolita number, man. Hope you win tonight.
Number 24.
24. Because I know where you live, I can deliver the stuff to you.
All right.
Thank you, Angelo.
All right, guys.
Take care.
Thank you.
Bye bye. You know, I was telling you about this the other day. Does anybody else besides me remember? And are there any questions? Darling, did you not tell us where you worked, how you worked there?
I did work there. I was a display manager for Lerner's for several years, and I worked at West Shore to begin with, but then I also went to Northgate and did those stores, put all the window displays together and hung things from filament wire up in the top of the ceiling to signs and stuff. And
that was you.
It was me.
Up on the ladder. Steve,
dressed the mannequins, all of that.
I didn't work there.
You dressed the mannequins?
I did dress
them. Male and female?
No.
Just female.
Just female.
No, my sister worked at a body shop. She worked at the body shop
there.
And speaking of logos and slogans, there's one here for the
Go
Colony
ahead.
Shop. Remember the Colony Shops?
Of course.
And their slogan was, "Where the girl goes who knows clothes."
Yes.
Where
I remember
the girl
the
goes
show.
Who knows clothes.
And my sisters all knew that slogan because
they shopped there.
That was a great
and
store.
And worked there as well.
I shopped there.
Spencer's was always fun to walk into
I
as well.
I used to love going
Spencer's.
To Spencer's.
Was cool, man, because, you know, they had kooky stuff.
Yeah, they did.
They had wild
they
stuff,
still
and it
do.
Was always fun to go in there at around Halloween because they always had the crazy stuff. And then in the back, they had the crazy, crazy stuff, remember?
And the black and posters.
Oh, no, but in the back.
Oh,
the adult
back
crazy stuff.
Yeah, they still have it. Still that way.
Where you go, went back there, and you look at that stuff. What's that? I don't know. You're 12 years old. What are you looking at that stuff for? Anyway. Let's show that picture real quick because we're running out of time. I can't believe we're running out of time already.
Zip.
Golly. Look at that shot of Moss Brothers.
Yeah,
right up at the
great.
Top there, the Suncoast restaurant where those windows are.
It was fabulous.
And you can tell by those cars it was probably the early 80s. I guess, the early 80s, late 70s, early 80s.
Yeah.
I think we had one more picture as well, Jeff. Let's throw that up there before we run completely out of time.
And then we have
look at that there. Look at the entrance to Woolworth.
That's beautiful.
And what Woolworth. Not Woolworth. Woolworth. And what I was going to say about this is in the back, you could come into Woolworth from the back. They had an opening, if I'm not mistaken, a door that led you to the... And you came in the back, but like at most drugstores. And why was it the drugstores? Like Eckerd's had this same little thing. They had this little swinging gate. Steve, we talked about it today.
You had to step on the
there
little
was a little swinging gate. You stepped on the black mat, and the swinging gate
would
went...
swing open.
I guess maybe like, was
real
it a
slow.
Security thing?
I think it was security to keep people from like grabbing something and leaving out the door. So the only way you could go was to pass by the cashier. You had to go around.
So.
But there was a little black button that everybody didn't know about that you could press that button and the gate would swing open. And I'm assuming that was for employees to be able to go the other way so they didn't have to walk all the way around. But Steve, you had an interesting little thing that you used to do with that little swinging gate. What was that that you used to do?
Well, I don't know if it's interesting or not.
Yeah, interesting. It's interesting as hell. Go
ahead. I mean, as a kid, I was fascinated by it. You know, that you had to step on that little platform.
Yes.
And I would just actually put one foot on real light and then slowly apply pressure down on my toe to see how much weight it took to make the swing the door
to
swing
make it work.
But I was inquisitive like that.
Very scientific.
Steve, Steve had a scientific mind even back then.
I did.
Even
yeah.
back
I had
then,
to figure
he was
out how things worked.
How things work. That's why he's our IT guy.
Nice.
That's why he does what he does. Stevie, I'm going to ring you a bell.
That's a bell, yeah.
That's
got
a bell.
It. Hey, you know
okay,
what?
I can't take it back.
I got a funny comment to read.
Because you can't unring a bell.
We got to read this comment. It has to do with
how much time we got left?
How much time?
We don't want to lose. We got to do a bullet drawing. Oh, six minutes.
Oh, we're
plenty
good.
Of time.
We're good.
Yeah. Weeks.
Because we just showed the Woolworth
Weeks.
Picture.
Yeah.
This was written on the Facebook page. It's from Michael Mulder.
Michael Mulder.
And check out this memory. He writes, I can remember this the distinct smell of Woolworth as you walked in, popping popcorn, chocolate-covered peanuts, and a slight scent of parakeet poop, and a dead goldfish as you walked past that and on your way back to the back of the store.
Wow.
Parakeet
poop, ladies and gentlemen.
I want to know what parakeet poop
parakeet
smells
poop.
Like.
It was just, I had to read that.
All right, let me
funny.
Just read real quick a couple of these, man, because we got a lot of them. We got 6 minutes. I'm going to rip and run. You want to read some, babe?
Sure.
All right, here, take that one. I'll take this one. Stevie.
Go ahead.
Grab, just follow me, man. I'm going to start with Chelsea. Chelsea DeHaven Shaw writes, JCPenney's, Learners, Walgreens, Oops. Spencer Gifts, Wolf Brothers, The Colony Shops, 579, McCann's Shoes. Then Arlene Bose-Kaminsky, and I think that's the lady who
that's
just
the
called
singing,
tonight.
Singing
she says, remember me? I was a singing waitress at Farrell's Ice Cream Parlor for the first summer I lived in Florida and just out of college. She also writes, yes to Chess King and also Little Ruben. High-end women's clothing. Lily
Ruben.
There's
yeah,
wrong
that
with
was
glasses.
Very high class.
Tony Zapponi writes, and before Dillard's, the place was
Upscale.
Called Robinson's.
Mm-hmm.
See, there you go, Tony Zapponi.
Maybe that's right.
My turn?
Yep.
Mike Larina,
mm-hmm.
I think there was a pet store called Doctor's Pet Center, and you're
right.
correct.
There you
they
go.
Sponsored our team at Palmacia. We were the Pelicans.
Nice.
What can I say?
Here's a great memory. Stephanie Thomas, my prom dress was bought at Moss Brothers. I worked at Brody's Yogurt and the Cookie Company. There was also
cookie
a game room
company.
By the food court.
Hey, here's an answer to that question. Brad Buckley writes, there was a Robinson's there, which became Robinson's Maison Blanc. Before they turned into Dillard's. Dillard's moved out in the International Mall and Sears came in.
Same
this
building.
Guy knows everything, yeah.
So I was right.
The grocery store was the grocery store next to Baskin and Robbins was Cash and Carry, where I worked for 13 years. That's the answer to the other question.
Yeah.
God, good job, Brad. Vicky White Kirshner writes, size 579 shops where a skinny girl like I was able to find good clothes that fit.
Yeah, I shopped there too.
Mm-hmm.
Linda Baker, I work at the Woolworths. Blowing up balloons during the holidays.
Helium balloons, of course. Stevie, go.
Here's a good one. This is Linda Baker. Oh, no, that's yours. Baker's Shoes was there, too. They were famous for their dyeable special occasion
yes,
shoes.
Yes, I remember
Don't let
Baker's
us run out of time. Yes. Janet Chilora Hammer writes, we watched the arrival of Santa Claus in the parking lot of West Shore Plaza from our house. Moss Brothers Restaurant was the bomb. What about Farrell's Restaurant? Giant ice cream. Pantry Pride was the best. There's a Pantry Pride.
Yeah.
And the pet store right next to Pantry Pride. Guess that wouldn't happen today. Clint Schaefer writes, had my first ice cream soda at West Shore Woolworth, or was it Walgreens? Was there Walgreens there too?
There
I remember
was.
Going there to see a sort of animatronic Christmas display at West Shore sometime in the late 1960s. Little spinning polar bears and lots of fake snow.
I remember seeing that.
Didn't see any of the real stuff in Tampa till the major snowfall in 1977. And I got to say real quick before we run out of time, because we are, I remember going there in high school and seeing what was billed as the abominable snowman. They had proof. Verifiable proof that they captured the abominable snowman. He was there in a sarcophagus, a box that was frozen. You paid 50 cents, you walked up like at the fair, and you looked down in it, and boy, was I disappointed, because it was just nothing but, it was like a hairy gorilla mask-looking thing underneath the ice, and you couldn't see it because it was all fogged up. How about that one?
Hey, how about Walton Books? The precursor to the big box stores.
Yes, yeah. Yeah. Walden yeah. Books as well. Thank yeah. you to all of our callers. We got to get to our believers.
And by the way,
let's show that real quick. And Stevie, you got to push that. You got to talk about this picture right quick.
Which one? Let's see.
Let's see.
This is
it's Festa.
Oh yeah, Festa Italiana.
Show that picture. Fade to black. Show that picture. There it is.
Yeah,
Stevie, talk about it real quick.
Well, we're all going to be there. Don't miss this event. It's Festa Italiana every year, 16th annual Festa Italiana. You can go to festaitaliana.com to get details. It starts Thursday, April 4th. It goes through to Sunday. That's right. April 4th, Thursday, Saturday, Sunday is the big day. And just go to festaitaliana.com, festaitalianatampa.com. What we'll do is we'll put a link on our website to tampanativeshow.com. But wonderful event.
Yeah,
and next
great.
Week we're going to talk about Festa again. So get ready, everybody, because cannoli's for everybody. Oh, Festa Italiana is about
food.
To happen again.
And those that send emails, by the way, let's write these down real quick. This is for Ricky T. Parnell, belated number 21.
Ricky T. 21.
I think it's taken.
Hustle.
No, Ricky T.
Okay, Marilyn Messina.
Marilyn Messina.
Yeah, belated number 51.
Marilyn Messina, 51.
51.
And I think that's it.
Okay.
No, wait, no, we have James Buckley.
Oh, 90 seconds?
Nope. No, belated number.
All right, here we go.
Okay, ready?
If I can say, I hope Miss Kaminsky wins tonight.
Well, first-time callers always win.
First-time caller.
Okay, here
and
we go.
And the singing waitress from Farrell's.
Number 20.
20 on the money. Boom. Closest two without going over. 21.
No,
she went over.
No,
number 18, Hugh Perrette.
Hugh Perrette got us again.
He's lucky, isn't he?
He's not going to win. I'm not going to ring the bell. He's not going to win. He wins every time. All right, Hugh, you won again. Stinker. We got about a minute to go.
A minute.
Wow, what a great show. Talking about West Shore. We didn't even get all of our emails, or I mean our comments out. Thank you to all of our callers tonight
yes.
that called, and to everybody that shared their memories.
What happened to the show? It just flew by.
We evaporated in
like
no time whatsoever, and I'm frustrated. But next week's show is going to be all about the end of our season. We come to the end of our sixth season now?
Wow. I think so.
Eighth season?
I think
we got almost 200 shows behind us. Oh,
thought,
my goodness,
what?
This is getting
no,
exciting.
Wait, I was
300
say.
Shows. We're down to 30 seconds. I don't know what I'm saying.
We're
actually, we're going to celebrate our 100th
show
in about 3 weeks. You guys stay tuned for that. Jeff Haynes, our technical director who's behind
thank
the
you.
TriCaster, thank you so much. Dory, we love you.
Feel
thank
better,
you for coming
Dory.
In, even though you're not feeling well. On behalf of Tampa Steve, how much time I got, Jeff? 10 seconds.
10 seconds.
And the 15-minute wow. girl, I'm Mario Nunez. We love you. We'll see you next week. We
you
love
do.
You, Tampa. Salud.
Salud.
And happy days.
We love you.
Back when we were younger and everything seemed new, we used to have a lot of fun. Yes, we did. No matter what we do, sleepy days, long summer nights, going anywhere we please, with love that I could call my own. Love that I've always known, the city that I call my home, a home from which I never roam. This love affair was meant to be. I love her and she loves me. I remember Tampa. Oh, she remembers me. She remembers me. TBCN, home of the Tampa Native Show.